Hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self, and today is day 39 of 99 Days, 99 Channels. And the topic for today will be asking the Higher Self to give us guidance during this time of financial instability that is occurring in the United States economy as well as the global economy. So I hope this channeling session will provide enlightenment and benefit all the viewers. You are the love. You are the light of God, the light of Source, pure and total in your nature, complete and whole as your being. You are God incarnate. So why, dear ones, why choose to suffer with the instability around you? Why choose to identify with limitation, to identify with separation, when who you truly are is God incarnate, children of God, one and the same, as birthed forth from the Father, from the Mother, that is the source of all that is. You yourself are whole. You yourself are complete. You yourself have all the divine abilities of manifestation, all the divine abilities to change this world inside yourself. Yet, dear ones, we ask you, do you wish to continue living the life of a slave? Living a life cut off from the natural world, cut off from the feelings that come by living amongst human beings. Dear ones, this is a time of economic decay, a time of dissolution of that which does not serve the higher purpose that is in alignment with your heart, with the heart of God, with the heart of this planet, with the heart of humanity, and in alignment with all life everywhere. For dear ones, why do you cling? Why do you grasp onto a system that does not serve you? A system designed to serve only the select few that are in power, that are in control over the masses, through manipulation, through lies, through deception. For the truth remains that you are children of God, that you are always provided for, that you are great manifestors. Yet that which is in disharmony with the will of God, with the law of love that is within your heart, all that is within disharmony will fall away. In time, it will fall away, for it is not being supported nor created by the will of the universal creator, nor by the will of higher dimensional beings existing here on earth and surrounding your planet with love and light, hoping, wishing, and knowing that consciousness on this planet is awakening. Consciousness is being restored as you human beings incarnate here are choosing to wake up and to create a reality that serves all of life. Dear ones, you are amidst a period of great change in what once was, and an introduction into what will be, an introduction of the truth of love, the truth of harmony, the truth of cooperation and companionship that will exist amongst the masses. For the system that keeps you believing in separation, that keeps you competing against one another, that keeps you living in fear for your survival, that system will fall away. For for that system is not in alignment with the universal laws that govern your planet, the universal laws that are creating this universe. So, dear ones, be not afraid during this time of change. Surrender your heart into the heart of God, and know that as the love pours into you from this source of life, from this source that you are, from this source that God is, you will be taken care of, you will be made whole again, and the consciousness of humanity will be raised to a high enough level to see the solution to all their problems. For the thinking that creates the solution is not the same thinking that is creating the problem. Your consciousness must raise higher to see beyond the limited perspective that you currently experience life through. You must find the solution in yourselves, and this will come by reuniting yourself with the source of divine intelligence within you, the source of light and love that is within your heart, the source that is always in alignment with the universal will. For the will of God, as it pours through you, through your higher mind, into your heart, will seek to raise humanity back into a state of divine perfection, into a state where humans once again live in harmony with all the worlds, live in harmony, acting through their heart, seeing life as love, as an expression of oneness, enjoying the diversity, yet not suffering because of limited identification, because of limitation existing within the human mind. For dear ones, you are whole and complete, and as you choose to embrace your completeness, as you choose to express from this place of wholeness, the world will be recreated in this image. You must become that which you wish to create. You must be the love that is within your heart. You must see yourself as a child of God, having been given all the creative powers that exist within you, moving through you, existing as you. For you are whole and complete, and as you see this of yourself, and as you see this of the world, it will begin to manifest. Suffering will be removed. Disease and famine will be a thing of the past, for you will know yourself as a child of God, as whole and complete. What you see in this world is the truth of your experience, not necessarily your individual truth, though that is reflected in your life, but also the collective truth of humanity, for we are all part of one living organism, living, cooperating, here and now, creating a common experience on this planet. And yes, as individual entities within the collective consciousness of humanity, we have choice. We have free will to create the life we want. We can choose to honor our hearts and live in harmony, creating a new world, a new way of being in which all are cared for, in which all are loved. Yet this transformation, dear ones, starts with you. It cannot be brought about through external means. You cannot force control from the outside.